Welcome to Dr. David Eifrig's Health and Wealth Bulletin. This is Weekly Update. This week, we're coming to you with the scariest topic we've ever discussed, superbugs. These are bacteria that are resistant to several types of antibiotics. That makes them very difficult to treat, and in many cases can make them deadly. We want to start by telling you about a woman in Nevada who, at the end of 2016, died from a bacteria called Klebsiella pneumoniae. The reason this is so scary is because this strain of bacteria was actually resistant to all 26 known antibiotics. That's something we haven't seen before, but unfortunately, we're probably going to see again. That's why today we want to talk about how superbugs are made and what we can do to help protect ourselves at the individual level. So the superbug that you're most likely familiar with is C. diff. That's because it's usually found in hospitals and even in some retirement homes. It's responsible for about 500,000 infections each year and 29,000 deaths. In addition to that, superbugs also account for about 2 million other infections and 23,000 deaths in the US. Although keep in mind, these numbers are from 2011 and they have increased over time. In fact, a report from Britain showed that the worldwide death rate from superbugs is about 700,000 every year. Now, the reason that we're talking about this today is because the worldwide use of antibiotics is skyrocketing. We just saw a report that it's up 65%. That's a huge increase, especially in countries like India and China. But even here in the US, even though we know the problems with overusing antibiotics, we still have not reduced how many we use. Now, the creation of superbugs is deceptively simple. The problem is that every time you expose the bacteria to a certain chemical, like an antibiotic, a few of those bacteria will survive. That's because of random mutations and things like that. However, if you keep exposing them to the same chemical, more and more of them are more likely to survive. It's part of their evolutionary benefit to keep staying alive every time you try to kill them. That's why if you're exposed to an antibiotic a lot, for instance, if you take it often enough throughout your life, and you take a lot of different classes of antibiotics, you're more likely to have problems with these types of antibiotic-resistant bacteria. Now, one of the biggest problems here is overprescription. In fact, in 2015, there was an article out of the Journal of the American Medical Association that found about 55 to 80% of all patients with acute bronchitis were prescribed antibiotics. Now, that sounds like a high number, and it should, because almost all cases of acute bronchitis are caused by viruses. The problem here is that viruses cannot be killed by antibiotics. Antibiotics only fight bacteria. So you're literally taking antibiotics when you don't need them. The problem is, if you do have any bacteria in your body, they're going to start getting antibacterial resistance. So now we want to talk about 5 tips that you can take to help keep you safe from antibiotic-resistant bacteria. Now, the first 3 involve your doctor. The first one is to find out if you have a bacterial or a viral infection. So the next time you go to your doctor and you're sick, ask them specifically to test to see if you have a bacterial infection. If you do, that's when you should be taking antibiotics. That's because should you have a viral infection like the flu virus, it's not going to respond to antibiotics and you're only setting yourself up for antibiotic-resistant bacteria. The second tip is to try a delayed prescription. Now, a lot of times our bodies will recover naturally if we have a bacterial infection. And that's why we recommend waiting and seeing if you really get worse. If you do go to the doctor and you're not quite sure if it'll go away on its own, ask them for a delayed prescription. What this means is they'll write you a prescription for an antibiotic, but it'll be dated a few days after your appointment. And that way, if you do still need it, you can go ahead and get it filled. The third tactic is if you should get a prescription for antibiotics, make sure you take the entire course of medication. You want to make sure that you wipe out all the bacteria. If you have an 8-day prescription, for instance, and you only take 4 days of it, there's still a chance some of the bacteria are hanging around and they're now building that resistance to the drug. Our fourth tip involves the hospital setting. If you're at a hospital, you want to see if they have a stewardship program in place. What this does is it keeps tabs on any prescription for antibiotics written by a doctor. It's usually monitored by a third party, like an infectious disease doctor or even a pharmacist, who can evaluate the situation and make sure there's no overprescription going on. And our fifth tip is one that we've talked about a lot before. It's the simple act of washing your hands with plain soap and water. That's all you really need to kill all of the bad bacteria that you might have on you, without the added problem of triclosan, which is the agent in antibacterial soaps. We've warned you about triclosan before because of the problems it causes with our hormones. It's a hormone interrupter. We also don't like triclosan because it's a direct contributor to the growth of superbugs. We hope these five tips will help keep you safe from antibiotic-resistant bacteria. But I know what you might be thinking. Is there really any hope for protecting ourselves if there are already bugs out there that are resistant to all known antibiotics? Well, there is some new hope on the horizon. In 2017, there was a big breakthrough in the antibiotic drug market with a drug called Taxobactam. The reason we're excited about this is because it's the first class of antibiotic discovered in about 25 to 30 years. That's really great news, and we're really excited to see how well it will perform in the coming months. We're going to keep you updated on this story, and in the meantime, please keep following our five tips and keep you and your loved ones safe. That's it for today. Don't forget to keep your comments and questions coming to our feedback line. Like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you next week.